Please stand. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our sorrows so that we can comfort others in their sorrows with the consolation we ourselves have received from God. Thanks be to God. Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Jerry Sitko. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
First reading today is from the book of Ruth, chapter 1, verses 16 to 17. And this is very special to me because these were part of our wedding vows. Ruth said, "Entreat me not to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there will I be buried. May the Lord do so to me and more also, if even death parts me from you.
Reading Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore.
Our musical piece that you are about to hear is the song O Holy Night, which you may think is a bit of a strange piece to hear in July, especially on a day when it's 100 degrees. But this was a very special song to Jerry, and he especially wanted to hear Gaga sing it and loved hearing her sing it at Christmas time, and we thought it was very appropriate for her to sing that piece for us today.
Thank you. The second lesson comes from Romans chapter 8, verses 35 through 39. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
I invite you to stand for the gospel.
Set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. There are many dwelling places in my Father's house. If it were not so, I should have told you, for I am going there on purpose to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I shall come again and receive you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. And my way there is known to you. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going. So how can we know the way? Jesus replied, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. And now we will have some sharing from family and friends, and I'd like to invite John to come on up.
Well, thank you all for coming as we remember my dad. You know, like him, I am typically not the most boisterous or talkative type, so in his honor, I will keep these words brief. I want to share one of my fondest memories. When we were children, maybe 5-ish years old, my sister and I had a favorite Saturday morning activity. And during the week, my dad would wake up early, around 5:30, 6 in the morning. Throughout my youth, I never understood how he could do it. I made him late dozens of times, trying to drag myself out of bed when he was going to drop me off at high school. Of course, my years in the Army fixed that, and now I regularly wake up at 4:30. But back then, when I was little, Saturdays were special because my dad would stay in bed longer, probably to spend more time with my mom. But on these days, my sister and I would sneak into the bed with him, and my dad would transform into the tickle monster. He would tickle us until we were gasping for air, and then he would pull us back and tickle us some more. I have never forgotten those magical mornings with pure elation and jubilance of a child being tickled. My son Isaac is autistic, and he can't really communicate. So it's hard to connect with him. But when I tickle him, and he gives me those same squeals of laughter that I did as a child, when he catches his breath and signs that he wants more, I always think back to those mornings with my dad. And I am so thankful for the lessons he taught me of the simple ways to connect to your son. He always believed in me. He didn't just encourage me, but he had an absolute conviction that I could accomplish great things. That support guided me through many hard times in my life. His support extended to his wife, my mom, Ruth Ann, as well. I soon learned that no matter how wild and unconventional my mom's position on a conflict was, my dad would always absolutely take her side. At least in front of me, I don't know what he said when I left the room. But this is a principle I've taken to heart. My wife might not believe this, but I always avoid saying anything negative about her to others. The world only gets to see my support. My dad set a remarkable example for me as he traces the lessons he taught me throughout my life. And like the best teachers, he didn't spend a lot of words telling me what to do. He just showed me over and over by how he lived his life. And I will miss these lessons that he taught me until the end.
John mentioned going into bed in the morning, because my mom tells me that when I was little, I used to run in and say, "Sun's up, get up." And I also remember one time I purposely went in, I took this round hairbrush and I purposely jammed it into my hair, and then one of them had to get up and fix it. Anyways, he was one of those dads who believed his kids could be whatever they wanted. He may not have used those exact words, but he demonstrated it by listening to our hopes and dreams and supporting us every step of the way. I've been a bit of a rambling ADHD kid my whole life, but he listened to every word and made me feel like they all mattered. He just smiled and listened to everything and said, "Yeah, you can do it." I'll just never forget that.
Like to invite Dick to come up and share some words as well.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Dick Curley is my name. I'm the friend that Ruth Ann refers to in her narrative, who traveled down from Monterey when Jerry and I were in the Army together to meet with cousin Claire. I think it was actually in Englewood, but it says in Torrance. I certainly do remember the apartment building on Queen Street. Many good times were had there with Claire and all her rowdy friends, along with Jerry. So I appreciate the opportunity to speak here today. I first met Jerry in the fall of 1968. That was a long time ago, as I'm sure you all know. He was already in the Army at that time for about 6 months, and he was stationed at Fort Ord, as I think many of you know, up near Monterey. And we soon became best friends for the next year and a half until Jerry got out of the Army. So last night, I plan to tell you some details about what Jerry did during his time in the Army, which was pretty impressive. But during the drive this morning, and earlier actually, I decided it was more important to tell you about the context, of the times that got Jerry into the Army in the first place. Go back to early 1968. Many of you, I can tell, remember those times. The Vietnam War was getting really hot. The nightly news had stories about the body count. Some of you remember that. They talked about how many enemy soldiers were killed by U.S. soldiers and how many U.S. soldiers were killed by enemy soldiers. It was a scary time. The military brass and their political leaders were worried that we would lose the war, and so their solution? Escalate. That is, draft more young men to go fight the war. And at the same time, the war was losing public support, and draft age men were devising more and better ways to avoid the draft. In fact, two of those young men went on to become President of the United States. At that time, Jerry was a new college graduate with a degree in STEM subjects, actually computer science and mathematics. And so his future was very bright. He had every reason to try to avoid the draft, even more to move to Canada, as some young men did. Instead, when he got the call, he answered. It's important to know that Jerry never went to Vietnam. He spent his entire time here in California, but that was the Army's decision. They thought he could contribute much more by staying here and continuing his work on Army computers. It's also important to know that he did not know what was going to happen to him on the first day that he was in the Army. For all he knew, he would end up in Vietnam carrying a rifle. So I say, good luck, buddy. Thank you for your military service. I salute you. Thank you.
Years ago this November, I decided to go for a walk with my newborn baby girl. As I headed down the street, I was accosted. Oh, I mean, I met Ruth Ann. She was packing their motorhome for a Thanksgiving camping trip, and she asked me, "Do you live around here?" I said, "Yes, I live right down the street." Well, she asked me for my phone number because we didn't have cell phones, we couldn't text, and she said she would call me after the holiday. And call me she did. We had lots of good times together. And not too long after that, I met Jerry, who my family, we all decided after spending time with them, that he became known as Saint Jerry. If you know Ruth Ann, you know she likes to go over and over and over the details. And Saint Jerry agreed with very few kind words. Our family spent birthdays, holidays, and lots of backyard fun together. One time we went to Castaic Lake to go on Jerry's sailboat. Jerry tried to convince Ruth Ann to go with him and fly the hull, which means lift the boat up like this, which she promptly declined and volunteered me. It was so fun and a very special memory I have of St. Jerry. Recently, while enjoying a glass of wine with Ruth Ann on her patio, I learned a story I had never heard before. Claire, Jerry's cousin, had been trying to set Ruth Ann and Jerry up for a date. Apparently, Ruth Ann was dating another Jerry and told her roommate to be sure when a phone call came in if it was Jerry number one or Jerry number two who had called. Well, she did break up with Jerry number one and had her first date with Jerry number two, Saint Jerry, on New Year's Day night. I only wish I could have heard Jerry tell me this story. I know it would have been hilarious with his calm, easygoing manner, and he would have laughed and I would have laughed, and it just would have been a special moment. I can hear his laugh, and I know he knows that he was always number one to Ruth Ann.
Is there anyone else who would like to come up and share any of your memories with all of us? I'm sure that you will all be sharing lots of good, wonderful memories of Jerry during lunch after the service. Now we are going to show a lovely memorial video.
I'll have to try. It's not easy.
Jerry was a kind, caring, and wonderful person who was beloved and important to so many people. This morning, we've heard stories from his life and his impact through those wonderful memories that have been shared. And We just saw this beautiful video that captures some of the important moments throughout the years. Jerry lived his life to the fullest. He did so much in his lifetime. He served in the army, he married the love of his life. He was a very active parent who was involved with all kinds of activities with his kids. He volunteered. He was an active and involved member here at Bethlehem. He traveled extensively and so much more. Today, as we are gathered here together, we give thanks for Jerry's life on earth. There is a lot to be grateful for as you remember all of the good times that you had with him. We are also gathered together here to give thanks for the promise that Jerry trusted in throughout his life, the promise of eternal life with Jesus. Jerry's faith was an important part of his life. He knew and trusted in God's love for him and for all of creation. He lived his life in a way that showed that he had confidence in the promises of baptism and new life in Christ. Jerry lived his life knowing and trusting that Jesus, our Savior, was born as a little baby in Bethlehem. In fact, I'm pretty sure that this is the first time I have ever heard "O Holy Night" sung as a part of a funeral. And it's especially unique to hear in July. But it's also such a wonderful memory of something that is deeply important to Jerry. The mere fact that it's one of his favorite songs really says something about the depth of his faith and the importance of Jesus in his life. He knew the thrill of hope that comes from knowing that the angel voices sang out on the night when Christ was born. Jerry knew that Jesus was born, lived, died, and rose again for him and for all of us. So as you grieve, remember this. Know that God grieves with you. And yet, even in your deepest sorrow, know that in God's gift of eternal life, there is hope. Jerry is God's beloved child. He is loved by God just as each of you here today are loved by God. This is our hope both in life and in death. Even in the deepest moments of sadness and loss, we are held in God's hand, and absolutely nothing can change that. Jesus Christ holds Jerry and all of us close no matter what. This is a connection that cannot be broken by anything. That's because we are connected to the love of God, not by our own strength, but by the strength of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are held together by a love more powerful than we could ever comprehend. In the 8th chapter of his letter to the Romans, Paul describes the strength of God's love for us. As we heard, he writes, "For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels or principalities, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." We are assured that because of this love, Jerry has life everlasting, and that we too have life everlasting, that we have life in heaven. And we are reassured that God's goodness and mercy are for us. In the gospel reading from John today, Jesus is speaking to his worried disciples. The disciples were worried because Jesus had told them about his coming betrayal and death. The disciples' hearts are troubled. And that's why Jesus says to them, "Set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me." These words of reassurance are also for us today. As your hearts are troubled and grieving, Remember that Jesus calls for you to set your troubled hearts at rest too. Remember that Jesus has promised that he has prepared a place for Jerry. This is our certain hope, that we can trust in Jesus' words, that he promises us that he has gone to prepare a place for Jerry and a place for each of us, that our home with God is forever. It's something you can trust on, something you can rely on. Jesus says to us, trust in God always, trust also in me. We know that Jerry had this trust and confidence, that he lived his life knowing that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. This afternoon, as you gather in fellowship for lunch, I'm sure you'll be sharing all kinds of stories from Jerry's life, the good memories of the times that you had together with him and the positive influences that he had on your lives. And as you remember and celebrate, I pray that you also find comfort and hope in knowing the peace and comfort that Jerry found in Jesus' promise of rest for our souls. May you too find that same comfort in Jesus. Amen. Amen. I invite you to stand to join us for our hymn of the day.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me."
Hallelujah.
You may be seated, and our ushers will guide you forward for communion. We have a couple of different communion options for those who need gluten-free bread or who wish to have individually packaged communion. We have gluten-free bread with grape juice, and then we have pita bread that can be dipped into either wine or grape juice. And all are welcome to join us for communion.
Thank you.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Jerry Sitko. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Amen. Sending song. To join the family for a time of fellowship, memories, and a meal together.